subjects have seen. Perhaps one of the leading luminaries of thought leadership across the entire spectrum of the globe. We have with us here this evening, ladies and gentlemen, a mind, a person, a human being, a thought leader, a writer, and above all, a communicator par excellence. We celebrate today the birthday of our beloved Professor Jagdish Seth. Perhaps he himself, in all his humility, does not know how many he has inspired. Like some gigantic oak, he has bred and nurtured a whole generation after him, who have looked up to the sky and seen that northern star, that pole star, that guides their lives. I say this because I am one of those, perhaps in the wilderness of the cosmic supernova, who have looked at that lodestar and said, if this be the man, can we try and emulate him even a little bit? Sir, you do not know, and in all your humility, you perhaps will always remain unaware of how many people you have inspired to greater heights. Even choosing today's topic, why the rise of India is inevitable. And I've heard him on 3 or 4 occasions when he talks so passionately about the country of his origin, the place that he belongs to. God has given him, the world has given him, the planet has given him so much, but he has earned his enormous reputation mostly in distant shores. But through all of that, we know that his heart beats for India. At every forum, he never tires to talk about why India is not only the cradle of civilization, why it is the nation of the future. In fact, very often I hear him say, that future is almost here. You can feel India on the runway about to take off. And he has, of course, many, many reasons, and you will listen to them today, as to why the rise of India is inevitable. I do not wish to preempt any of the things that he says, not to indulge in a debate as to whether that is inevitable or not. I will only say this, that at the IILM, Institute of Higher Education, one of the things that we have held very dear to our heart is the idea of sustainability. We've held 6 conferences, international conferences, at the epicenter of which has been the evolution of the thought process of sustainability and how it has been today ingrained into the way that corporate leaders think. If there is any idea that has literally taken over the world today, it is the idea of the Sustainable Development Goals. And we at that institute hold those 17 principles very dear to our heart. I say this also because among the million things that Professor Jagdish Seth actually writes about or does, his most recent book, which I had occasion to just briefly browse through, is titled Developing the Sustainable Edge, written in collaboration with Dr. Suhash Apte. It is in this book that he has penned these incredible words, saying, engaged business leaders and their employee teams can successfully drive sustainability at every level and with every stakeholder, thus maximizing the company's sustainability edge. In that book, he has, of course, many strains of thought, some of which are important for us today to understand. The motivation of consumers, collaborating with customers, inspiring employees, nurturing suppliers, investing in communities, the very heart of CSR and sustainability, thereby attracting a new evolved level of investors, leveraging the media, and finally, and I'm glad you saved that for the last, engaging governments. It always seems to be that governments wake up at the very end. I'm not sure whether that is true, but the way your message is resonating through the corridors of whatever we have, corridors of the establishment, you will receive, Professor Seth, a great deal of response from governments. Today, whether it's Davos or whether it's any conclave where business leaders and government leaders come together, we have, how timely that Kamal Singh, the UN Global Compact Chief, is here with us today to sustain that dialogue. Literally, absolutely the right time we're talking about sustainability. So even that holds well for all of it. So thank you, Professor Seth. You have been, for all of us, a great inspiration. You have written, I think, one of the finest books today on sustainability. And one of the things that is going to be for India, the rise being inevitable, is because our business leaders, our thought leaders, our policy makers are today firmly wedded to that concept of sustainability. With these few words, and welcoming you very warmly once again, wishing you not only a very happy birthday, but to stay always the way you are, vital, inspiring, motivating for all of us. And we hope all of you at the end will give you a standing ovation. Thank you.